high, hooked on a feeling. I'm high on I'm an alligator. I'm a mama papa coming for you. I'm the space invader. I'll be a rock and rollin' bitch for you.
Drew!
Yeah.
I'm already doing that video.
It's a Drew!
Hey look, it's a Drew, everybody!
I caught a Dan go. Oh wait, he's filming the thing.
I'm already filming. That's an Emily too!
It's like a real camera?
It's a viewception. Are we on two channels at once?
We're on two channels at once! Crossover, right, baby!
If you're subscribed to Movie Reviews, you'll see the different angle.
And if you're subscribed... If you're subscribed to vlogs, you'll see that, too.
Subscribe I'm listening to vlogs.
I'm listening to the soundtrack. Because I can...
Oh, it's so good. Volume 2.
No, no, volume 1. I'm sucking up.
Okay.
Smoking like a big monkey bird, and I'm busting out my face for all the world.
I don't know the words that much.
Must have been through about a million girls. I love the man to leave them alone.
Okay, I'll stop.
Oh, Dan, I have a great story.
Guess what we're seeing tonight? More on this
Boss
later.
Baby.
No, nope, that's not right at all.
Oh, Dan.
That's awesome.
You loved the soundtrack, didn't you?
I loved the soundtrack.
Did he mention the soundtrack?
Did I mention the soundtrack?
Did you like the first movie soundtrack?
I did like the first movie soundtrack.
What about this movie soundtrack?
Mommy's all right. Daddy's all right. They just seem a little weird. Surrender.
What did you think?
I enjoyed it a lot.
Okay.
I was not expecting... Okay. At one point when we were talking about this, I know I said something about how I was expecting Kurt Russell to be the bad guy.
You called that.
I called that.
About a month before the movie came out.
I didn't realize he was going to be a freaking planet, though.
Because that is a bit of a twist, isn't
that
it?
That was like, whoa!
You're like, in the trailer, you're like, why are they showing the dad reveal so early?
Yeah.
And then you watch the movie and it's like, 10 minutes in, you figure it out. And then no, Kurt Russell's not Kurt Russell.
Kurt Russell is a planet.
He is God. Essentially.
With a lowercase is what he said. Lowercase G God.
So is he assuming that there's a...
He knows, yeah. In the canon of Marvel, there are weird things.
I found this movie hitting all of the same Marvel check marks. It's similar to my opinion on Doctor Strange.
Okay.
It's like, everything's there. Except this is definitely more of a comedy.
Yeah, this is more... I think Guardians of the Galaxy has always strived to be more of a comedy.
It has. I mean, it's...
Which is not a bad thing.
When Chris Pratt is your...
Yeah.
You gotta take advantage of that, I understand.
Yeah, exactly.
And this, you'll laugh throughout it.
Mm-hmm.
Even in the...
Taser face!
Even in the... Make sure we're in focus.
Yeah.
Darkest of moments in the most epic... scenes, you'll find yourself laughing. Like, there's one in particular that always gets me, because I've seen it twice now in the past 24 hours, is Peter and his dad are fighting, like, the end of the Matrix, where they can fly and they can move rocks and create things.
Exactly.
And they're charging at each other.
The dad makes a person out of stone.
He makes himself bigger with stone, and he's about to punch Peter. He's like, so Peter turns himself into...
into Pac-Man. He turns himself into freaking Pac-Man.
Like an 80-foot tall stone moving, and even makes the sound, I think, Pac-Man. That's just, wow, wow. And it's just the most, it's supposed to be an intimate, like, deadly scene. But you're going to laugh throughout the whole thing.
It's hilarious.
But, can you think of anything that's wrong with it? Other than, see, to me, it's the classic Marvel villain not making much sense. Having seen it twice now, I tried to understand Ego's perspective again.
Yeah.
I still don't.
That's kind of, now that you bring it up to me, I'm kind of confused as to how that works.
Because I am God, I must destroy everything.
I must make everything in my image, maybe? Well, his name is Ego, so he's probably just a narcissist.
That makes sense. He's Peter Quill's father. He's just obsessed.
That's my freaking dad! That was a great line.
Of course, such a good line. Yeah, I thought it's an airtight script, though.
Yeah, airtight.
Characters.
James Gunn seems to know what he's doing with Guardians.
He does. Good on him. I don't know if he's returning.
I hope he is.
Future... Will there even be a Volume 3 before Infinity War?
I don't know. Hopefully.
I don't remember that being enough.
Oh, I can think of one thing that's wrong with the script.
What's that?
It apparently thought Zune was relevant.
No. That was intentional. Okay. That was a tech joke. That was like everyone on Earth's listening to the Zune nowadays.
Yeah.
It was like...
Peter Quill's going to get to Earth and be like, what the hell?
So, at this rate, by Phase 6, he'll have an iPod.
Yeah, right.
So, like, when he's 60 years old,
mm-hmm.
he'd be like, this rectangle is amazing.
It just plays songs after another. It is an excellent rectangle.
I really appreciated the turn of Yondu.
Yeah. And I like the development between that Nebula got. I thought that was cool.
Mm. Yeah, because they both
Really kind of got shot. Nebula more so. Yondu was just kind of a neutral party, I think.
You didn't like him or hate him?
I didn't hate him.
Yeah, he was like the protagonist's bad guy. In this one, he positions himself to be more of a father.
Yeah, yeah.
Right before he dies.
Of course.
But of course, it's Marvel, so.
Yeah.
It might not mean anything.
I was half expecting him to pop back to life in the funeral.
Yeah, you asked me.
I was like, is he really? Yeah. Is he actually dead or is he alive? It's like, no, he's dead.
After I said, no, he's dead, Dan, I was considering saying, it's Marvel. Dead means Netflix original. Even though they burned him with rainbow fire.
Yeah, that was different.
And I totally forgot Sylvester Stallone is in this franchise.
Yeah. It's like, that's a thing we can say now. Rambo is in the MCU.
Academy Award winning Sylvester Stallone.
You know what? It's not okay. I actually remember a status a friend of mine made.
Yeah.
And she said something like, I especially like the part where David Hasselhoff said, we are Groot. And I thought she was just trolling, like, just saying something random. I didn't realize, she was actually serious.
Yeah, was that Hasselhoff?
That was Hasselhoff. Movie?
Okay.
Yeah.
And that confused me because I don't know.
Yeah,
nostalgia.
And then that one point where, Kurt Russell morphs into David Hasselhoff, I'm like, weirdest, randomest cameo ever.
Like, the first opening scene of the movie, you see young Kurt Russell.
Mm-hmm.
And
good God, he looks so, so CGI and makeup. I'm like, he's really trying to get back to that 1985.
I think the wig was supposed to distract you from the CG, though.
No, everything...
because at both showings we went to, as soon as you see Kurt Russell, everyone in the theater starts laughing.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think it's intentional.
No.
There were definitely intentional laughter in the movie, but that was not one of them.
Mm-hmm.
It was just the...
Mantis is freaking adorable!
You love Mantis.
I love Mantis! I wanted to hold her and be like, it's okay!
Have her little, she'd feel you and then be all,
hey, you are excited to be with me.
Yeah. Because she can just read emotions. Mm-hmm. And I love the way Drax just completely demolishes her all the time. Mm-hmm. So it's just, you are hideous.
Yeah.
You are horrible to look at.
Yeah.
And then he thinks she wants to be with him physically, and he's like, she's like, I don't even like the type of person you are.
I don't even like whatever you are. I don't need to get personal.
And he goes, hey, boundaries. I still love Drax.
And the beginning with ELO is that was nice. That was, and he Drax tries to.
I love that opening scene. I thought that was clever.
I like how Drax tries to freaking kill the beast from the inside. they're just like going over the logical inconsistencies, like.
Skin on the inside.
It's probably just as thick as the skin. I tried to tell him that.
He's in the inside.
And he's just like,
I must say that the effects and everything stood out to me a lot.
God, the makeup artists in these movies get paid so much.
They must, yeah. Because I know there's definitely not a lot of practical.
No.
But, in fact, like 80% of the movie, I'm pretty sure, is animated. But
yeah, but...
looks good. Like, I remember...
It looks like good animation.
Yeah, when I remember watching Doctor Strange and just thinking, yeah, this is what you can do with a computer. But there's several scenes in this where it's like, no, you could have done that real, so they did.
Yeah.
Like, that's what I appreciate James Gunn for. I think every chance he could to...
I think he does, yeah.
Like, they didn't want a raccoon puppet, but...
No. But they,
there were scenes where they were fighting the alien where it looked like part of the tentacles that were...
Like, it looked like it was actually there.
Yeah. They had some, like, props they were swinging around.
Yeah.
And I was like...
It's like, good on you.
Good on you!
And I thought
it's a proud, proud effect.
I know we're talking about a superhero movie, so acting shouldn't be, like, first priority. But no. I thought it was good. I thought, like... I mean, like...
All of them were born to play those roles.
Oh, yeah.
Like, Drax was... That act, Dave Bautista was a wrestler, so he's like, I got the perfect part for you. He's someone just, who plays everything straight and doesn't get sarcasm.
He's like, perfect.
You literally have to hire someone else to act for you.
And then you get Vin Diesel, and he's just like, I will say everything in every language in three words. Done.
I can't believe. I hope Vin Diesel got the least pay for this.
I wouldn't be surprised if he took a cut to it, just because he's like, you know what,
I hope he didn't. I wouldn't pay someone to say three words, and then they chipmunk it so you can't tell it's you anyway, because Baby Groot doesn't sound like Vin Diesel. I love that scene where Baby Groot takes down a hole, and he's screaming, he's like,
yeah,
and that made me think of the meme where it's like when your girlfriend's trying to fight you, but she's like... yells adorably. It's like angrily cuteness.
Anything bad we can say about it?
I don't... Again, to me, the biggest problem is the villain not making sense, but that's classic Marvel. But that's not to say it's an unpleasant experience at all.
I'm still just banking on the whole, okay, he's a planet. I don't know how to read a planet's thoughts, even though it has a brain. Interesting.
It's fairly weak motivations, but at least I remember the name.
Yeah. Ego.
I can't remember the villain name for Thor the Dark World. That's
Malachite.
Really?
Something like that.
That's impressive, Dan. Not anyone can do that.
I can't remember the Doctor Strange villain, though. I just call him Hannibal.
Oh, yeah. Jyn Erso. No, Galen Erso.
There you go.
That actor.
Michael Madsen.
Who... Yeah. But, I mean, this one, it's like, yeah, you know the villain is...
Yeah.
Kurt Russell, the planet.
Yeah, it's just like, when the music swelled as he said he was his father, I was just like, easy.
Yeah.
Don't make it... We know already.
I knew he was bad the second that, like, hey, we're 10 minutes into the movie and he revealed himself. Mm-hmm. It's like, okay.
Yeah.
But there's scenes where he's, like, building his body.
That was so cool. I was like...
His whole bones.
Oh!
And they did it slowly, where he's talking, and you see the skeleton, and then you see the organs and the muscles, and I was like, okay, so we do face capture.
Yeah.
These people took x-rays of Kurt Russell and built it.
Those are my favorite, like, scenes, just seeing it all materialize and just...
Oh, I'm curious what the budget was. I'm wondering if it's substantially higher than usual. I'm sure it was.
Yeah.
But...
So, yeah, go watch it.
Yes. No, you will enjoy it.
This is a good movie.
If you have an IMAX, you'd probably enjoy it in that. Yeah. I don't recommend 3D to anything.
Yeah,
but
because that's cancer.
Because it sucks. Takes away from the experience. It shrinks the
screen.
You
want to take this bucket, by the way?
Yeah, we're going to add this to our collection.
Yes, our bucket collection.
We have three now. And, yeah, what would you give the letter grade?
I think what you said was pretty spot on, a B plus.
Yeah, and the only thing taking it away from an A is there's not much new brought. It's essentially like, see, a lot of people keep asking, is it better or worse than the original?
I think it's on par.
Like, yeah, it's really hard to tell.
Which is not a bad thing to say. Like, no. A lot of sequels really have the problem of actually being as good.
Mm-hmm.
Because...
But I can see a lot of people saying that the introduction of all those characters at the first time was more interesting to see them come together. But I would argue that the ending of the first one was so by the books and just space battle.
Oh, I just realized something.
What's that?
A foreshadow thing for Quill.
What?
Where Drax says something about how he always thought that Yondu was Peter's dad.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God. That's
a little play.
Drax is more perceptive.
And then Rocket's like, he's blue! You look exactly alike. Yeah, and then they just hold on Rocket for a second, and Rocket's just...
Yeah.
they get that animation down. It's a good combo, but it's definitely
one of the... What's up with your triangle face? It's just like...
And then it holds on him for a while, and he's like...
He's just like, am I?
You really feel for those characters.
You really do.
They do a good job.
Oh, I need gas. Wow.
Yeah, you do. I was going to say the alert's on.
Yep.
They introduce many characters and get you invested in all of them efficiently.
Yes.
Unlike Suicide Squad.
Okay.
Which didn't, EC. By the way. I mean, I'm not defensive about that. Or
I can tell. Anyway, that is our experience and
B plus.
Our view. B plus, yes.
An A would require a tad more originality.
A tad.
Mm-hmm.
But still good on its own.
Yeah. And enjoy.
Enjoy.
Go watch it.
See you in the next one.
Apple sheep.
Danny Movie Man. Have a good day.